Acquire power. Prayer is to acquire power. So when you're looking for power, a man of prayer is a man of power.
That's right.
See, people like Elijah, oh, very powerful guy, fire coming out, he prayed a lot. See, a man like Jesus, fire. He prayed all night, so he's very powerful. How many people want to be powerful here? Let me see your hand. You want to be, to have power. Okay, so you must spend time in prayer, in praying. You must spend time in praying. So prayer is not just for pastors or bishop or archbishop. Prayer is for everybody who want to have fellowship with God. Who want to make a mark. Prayer is for you. Prayer is for you. Say, I love prayer.
I love prayer.
Say, I love prayer.
I love prayer.
Yes. So prayer is to acquire power. Prayer is to acquire power. Jesus Christ went 40 days and 40 nights. Bible says, in return in the power of the Spirit. He went to pray 40 days and 40 nights. In return in the power of the Spirit. Moses went onto the mountain to pray. When he came back, they couldn't look at his face. Was like fire in his eyes. The place of prayer is a place of fire. I will not forget a testimony that one of our ministers shared with me. There was this man of God. He said, he stayed and prayed for 6 hours. How many hours?
6 hours.
Continuously.
Yes.
And then, after finished praying for 6 hours, he went and took a public transportation. And then there was a lady who came in into the bus and sit near him. I think maybe the lady was possessed. And he said, oh, fire, 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 fire. He stopped the bus until he went down. He couldn't sit in the bus with the guy. Because a man of prayer is a man of fire. Don't joke with a man of prayer. Are you getting me now?
Yes, sir.
Don't joke with a man or a woman of prayer. They carry fire around them. Say, I will pray.
I will pray.
Say, I will pray.
I will pray.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Now, another thing that you get in the place of prayer is dominion. Dominion. What God gave to man in the beginning. Man was fellowshipping with God day and night. So in the place of fellowshipping, which is the place of prayer, you get dominion over demon, over any form of sickness and diseases. You have dominion. You just say, I can't be sick. Now, you are not praying that I can't be sick because you already prayed. So you always say, no, I can't be sick. You say, ah, check it. Let's check God. You say, there's nothing to check. I can't be sick. You say, but just go and see the doctor and say, see doctor for what? I say, I cannot be sick. You don't just say it with ordinary mouth. You get it in the place of prayer. You get dominion in the place of prayer. You get it?
Yes.
You get dominion in the place of prayer. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Let's look at Acts chapter 3. Acts chapter 3 verse 6. We start from verse 4. Act 3. Let's start from verse 3.
Who saved Peter and John about to go into the temple?
Yes.
Asked for alms.
Yeah, for alms.
And fixing his eyes on him with John, Peter said, look at us. So he gave them his attention.
Let's start from verse 1.
Now Peter and John went up together to the temple at the hour of prayer.
At the hour of prayer, yes.
The ninth hour.
Yes.
And a certain man lame from his
birth. So you see that Peter and John are people of what?
Prayer.
They are people of prayer. So you don't just see a layman say, oh yeah, rise up and walk. No, he won't rise up. He will not just say, I can't. You say, let me say, I cannot, I want to. Because you are not a man of prayer. So Peter and John is a man of prayer. They went, they always go every time. It's a normal thing for them. Some people just say, call it to one prayer, it's like you are killing them. Prayer is a very big deal to them. But if you want to make a party now, oh, body will be order. But prayer is a place of dominion.
Come on.
It's a place of dominion. The church has missed it. Just having fun, music. Prayer is a place of dominion. Do you want to be in place of dominion?
Yes.
Some few people?
Yes.
Everybody?
Yes. I want to be in place of dominion.
Yeah. That not everything answer to you. Everything answer to you. Okay, read on.
And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful.
Yes.
To ask alms from those who enter the temple.
Yes.
Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple,
yes,
asked for alms.
Yes.
And fixing his eyes on him, uh-huh, with John, Peter,
yes,
said,
yes,
look at us.
Yes.
So he gave them his attention,
yes,
expecting to receive something from them.
Yes.
Then Peter said, silver and gold I do not have,
uh-huh,
but what I do have, yes, I give you.
I have dominion over this, what is worrying you.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth,
that is the power.
Rise up and walk.
Rise up and walk.
And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength.
That's
Amen.
It.
Amen.
You can't have that name of Jesus without being a man of prayer. You got it in the place of prayer. So please don't let people beg you to come and pray again. Say, I will come for prayer.
I will come for prayer.
Say, I will come for prayer.
I will come for prayer.
Say, I will love prayer.
I love prayer.
Say, I love prayer.
I love prayer.
You must. Glory be to God. Now, the third one is hearing from God. Hearing from what? From God. In the place of prayer, you hear from God. In the place of prayer, you hear from God. So when some people say they hear from God, they are men of prayers. So if you are not hearing from God, you know what is happening? It means you are not praying. Or if you are praying, you are not praying enough. Or if you are praying the wrong prayer. Now I've shown you the method of how to pray today. I've shown you the result of what you get from prayer. So if you are a wise man or a wise woman, you know what to do. If you are a wise man or a wise woman, you know what to do. If you are a wise man or a wise woman, you know what to do. Let's look at Genesis chapter 32. Let's start reading from verse 24.
Then Jacob was left alone.
Yes.
And the man wrestled with him until the breaking of day.
Yes.
Now when he saw that he did not prevail against him,
yeah,
he touched the socket of his hip, and the socket of Jacob's hip was out of joint as he wrestled with him. And he said, let me go, for the day breaks. But he said, I will not let you go unless you bless me. So he said to him, what is your name? He said, Jacob. And he said, your name shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel. For you have struggled with God and with men and have prevailed. Then Jacob asked, saying, tell me your name, I pray. And he said, why is it that you ask about my name? And he blessed him there. So Jacob called the name of the place Peniel, for I have seen God face to face, and my life is preserved.
You see now, it's a place of prayer, it's a place where you see God.